Hi there. Welcome to Russian with a Russian. My name is Diana Dank, and today we're going to learn how to speak with a Russian accent. I know there are a lot of videos about it. I watched many of them. But the more I watch, the more convinced I am that nobody can teach you a foreign accent better than a native speaker. Let's begin. The first thing you have to learn is that there is only one sound, E, in Russian. It is E. That's why most Russians pronounce the words fish and big like fish and big. And that is also why they don't understand the difference between the phrases I like this beach and I like this bitch. Try to say this. I see a really big fish with a Russian accent. I see a really big fish. Number two. There is only one sound in Russian. That's why we don't feel the difference between bad and bad. And that's why we pronounce the phrase, the fear of being bad in bed, like this. The fear of being bad in bed. Or, I had a hat, it was on my head. We pronounce like, I had a hat, it was on my head. Number three, weird stressing. In English, there is an upward cadence at the end of questions. Do you want to go to the park? And in Russian, the stress is often somewhere near the middle of the sentence. Ты хочешь пойти в парк? And we do the same thing in English. Do you want to go to the park? Number four. W's become V's. There is no such sound in Russian. That's why we often replace it with a V. And why do you like the woods becomes why do you like the woods? But to be fair, not all Russians make this mistake. They do quite the opposite. If they have just learned the sound W, they use it everywhere. For example, wary instead of very. So, you can go with both options. Number five. Forget about the TH sound. Now you will only say Z or S. Don't worry if people don't understand you, because by this point they'll be too scared to try and correct you. So, take the short pass to get to the theater. Number six. How do you like the greenhouse? Yes, the letter H. We have a tough time with this letter. In English, the sound is aspirated, and in Russian, the tongue is pressed to the hard palate, and on the exhale, you get the sound H. Try this. H. H. Try to say hello or how can you have a hand like a scissor? Number seven. ING ending. What are you doing? Yes, you should pronounce every letter, literally. Doing, watching, dancing. You'll be fine. Number eight. The letters D and T. They are different from the English D and T. So try to touch your lower teeth with the tongue when pronouncing them. Do you like dancing? You are so beautiful to me. Number nine. I am Russian. Yes, you should roll your R's. But many associate tongue rolling exclusively with Spanish. The Russian roll is perhaps even a little slicker because it's a shorter sound that doesn't really affect the flow or stress of the word, making it generally much less noticeable than in Latin languages. Try lightly flicking the tip of your tongue against the roof of your mouth. R, 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 Russian, Russian, Russian. Number 10. In Russian, we don't have articles. Their usage seems very tricky. So even those who speak fine English will mess this up from time to time.
This is beautiful girl. I bought nice car.
These were the most popular tips to use when learning how to speak with a Russian accent. I hope that you found this video useful. If you want not only to speak with a Russian accent, but also speak the Russian language itself, subscribe to my channel and learn Russian with me.
Have a nice day. I'll be back. Your Russian with a Russian.